Hello again, everybody. Getting an even later start tonight. But yeah, she had to walk a little ways to get to the next part of her story. I said I was going to try to get the next part of the Kaladbog stuff done, maybe. But it's really cold here, and I don't know how long I'm actually going to be able to stand sitting at the computer, because it's really cold. It's like 15 degrees. So I'm trying to at least get a story knocked out, because that seems like it would be quicker than doing the Kaladbog stuff. But we'll see. I mean, I've done the story before, but hey, it's been a while. Anyway, if you hadn't watched the last story video, this is my Sylvari Reaper, Nocturna Tyrell, and the reason I'm doing base game story on her is because I wanted to take a Sylvari through the hot story from the beginning, and I was trying to do that with my Sylvari Necromancer, but she's already done that entire story, so you don't really get to see any awards, any of the rewards and stuff, so I wanted to show it to you with the rewards actually showing up, so if you, by chance, actually hadn't done the story, you at least will know what you get from it and stuff. I mean, yeah, you could look it up, but watching somebody else do it is more fun than reading about it, right? Right? Sure it is. But anyway, yeah, the next part of her story, it's still the level 70 story, Marshaling the Truth. And I still have a sore throat. Now, I think that after this, I have to go really far away, so I might do something I usually don't do, which is, put two videos together. Usually just try to keep everything in one video, but if I gotta like walk through like three zones, I don't know if I want to record all that, and I don't know if you'd want to watch all that, but we'll see. That's why I started a little later tonight, because I had to walk her to her star before starting to record. But anyway, here we go. Level 70 story, Marshaling the Truth. And bring on the first annoying loading screen. I do apologize, my throat is getting really, really even worse than it normally is, probably because it is only 15 degrees. But at least that loading screen wasn't horrible. And yes, there is fighting in this story, if I recall correctly. So let's get out the minions, which I won't use once she gets all of Reaper trained, but right now she's only got like 24% of it trained, so... As you probably know if you've watched my other videos, I'm really not a big fan of melee fighting, but, you know, it's Reaper, and I played Reaper a bit in beta. Didn't annoy me too bad, so I'm going to try to use her sword for a while, but, I start taking damage, I'll probably go back to range for a bit. Because, like I said, she's only got, like, a quarter, not even a quarter of her Reaper traits trained so far. And yes, I have to click my Condor mover because it's ground targeting. Plus, I don't have a super special mouse with 800 buttons on it, so, you know. And even if I did click to use my Condor mover, it wouldn't normally work when I'm on a ranged character, which is what I'm normally on, because it would put it on the target, since I've got it locked to target in options, because I just like that way better, but for Condor mover. You gotta click. Although, it's not... I guess that's one advantage to melee. I actually probably could get away with not clicking it when I'm doing melee, because... Yep, see? Still wants to go over there. But yeah, I was gonna say, because my target and me are usually in the same place. Are we done? I thought there was more to it than that. I thought there was more to it. Interrupting our convention of necromancers with greatswords. Stupid grubs. Because, you know, everybody loves hanging out with Jaharn. And I've even got my Marjorie Mini. Everywhere you look, there's a necromancer with a greatsword. Although, right around Hot Story, I got a little perturbed with Marjorie, but we'll talk about that when we get to it. Let's just say it has something to do with the fact that I play 10 Sylvaris. So, yeah, me and Marjorie aren't getting along too well. Starting with the Heart of Thorns story. Although I like her better than other NPCs these days. See Living World Season 3, Episode 3? Okay, anyway. Now what are we doing? Destroy the undead ship. You want me to use something stupid, don't you? A mortar. I don't like using those things. They annoy me. And now I'm, like, conditioned to death here. It's like they were just waiting for me to get on the mortar. Actually, let me heal up before I screw this thing. I'm so bad at this. I'm getting conditioned to death again. Have to heal. I'm so bad at those, and it doesn't help when you're getting conditioned to death the whole time. What if I don't want to go there? So that was pretty short, like what, 10 minutes? So they want me to go to Fort Trinity. Huh. She's probably got that? I'll have to check. I'm writing down the name of the instances that I have in the video so I can put them in the description. But anyway, the Battle of Fort Trinity. I've never tried to do that on a melee tune, so could be fun and exciting. Now let's see. I think she's got that. Maybe. Maybe not. Nope, doesn't look like it. Now, I might be able to take the Asura gate there. And actually, no, I can't, because you have to do this before you do the quest for the use of the Asura gate. So, it looks like I'm going to have to walk. Oh, boy. Water waypoint. I'm gonna have to walk from Breckwater waypoint, it looks like. So, I guess I'll stop it there and then pick it up when I'm at Fort Trinity. So, we'll see. So, I will see you in a minute. Okay, here we are back again. It's been about 10 minutes, because of course I had to stop to transfer ugly gloves and harvest everything between the last story and this story, and there's an event right on top of the star. So, you know, good times. But let's move on and get into this next part. Battle of Fort Trinity. Like I said, I've never tried to do this on melee tune, so we'll see how long before I end up switching to staff. Alrighty, let's do this.
Glitches in communication. Fort Trinity is not yet secure. Worst of all, our Asura gates aren't functioning, and nobody can tell me why. Magical or mechanical failure, saboteurs, it's all very disturbing. I want you to double check our defenses, starting with the lumber camp. They've lost a lot of workers, and we need that timber.
So, how come Traherne knows how to pronounce saboteurs, but Commander Talon from Claw Island doesn't know how to pronounce trebuchet? They should have taken the same French class together, I say. But anyway, alright, let's go get attacked by 700 zombies. Not that I've done Battle of Fort Trinity before or anything. But like I said, I just want to get her caught up so I can start her fresh at the beginning of season 2 and Heart of Thorns, because she hasn't even done season 2 yet. I really did not enjoy a lot of the instances in Season 2. I mean, I liked the story, but the fights did not make me happy. Zombies found us. Alright. Let's see how long I stick to the greatsword. We'll see. Because it's not just, you know, that I don't like close combat fighting. I just don't like having to constantly chase after them every time they, like, run off and crap. I like being able to attack them the second I see them instead of having to run clean over to them before I can attack them. It just annoys me. But, oh well. Like I said, I don't mind Reaper, but I've always been more comfortable with ranged. But I usually do melee on my revenants, too. I mean, I have hammer on them all for certain fights, but most of the time I'm usually doing melee with them. And also, Daredevil, I usually do melee with. Too many zombies. Don't want to talk to any of you. Now, on most characters, the number 2 skill is usually the best one. But I think on Reaper, the number 3 weapon skill is the best one. Does the most damage at any rate. Do not confuse me. I don't like confusion. It just annoys me. No line of sight? What are you talking about? If I can see him, there's a line of sight. Yeah, as many times as I have done this, I always, get lost running around inside and having to find switches and crap. Oh, that's a lot of conditions. Chaos Storm. Thank you. I wanted a cutscene when I had like 4 million conditions on me and 300 zombies in my face. That's a great time for a cutscene. Thank you. Yes, there's giants. We know. Maybe we should run inside. I'm so psychic. It's like I know what they're gonna say before they say it. Use the first gate switch. In other words, kick it. I do think they look pretty darn funny when they kick things, though. They get a little overzealous with it. You guys will be fine. Alright, anyway. Defend Fort Trinity Ducks. Now, how many tries is it going to take me to get to these? Okay. It's the second time I got to go back that I can never find them. Zombies everywhere. Out of the water, zombie. Zombies don't float, do they? They all float down there. Okay. Yes, that is a reference to a really old Stephen King movie, and if you don't know it, you should be ashamed of yourself. Tim Curry was in it, man. Come on. He went from playing Dr. Frank to playing the clown in It. That's diverse. I think he took a break in between to play the butler and Chloe, too. But anyway. That dude, isn't that cutscene? It's like, does he ever do anything other than just stand there? Alrighty. Okay. Hey, more zombies, huh? Why am I getting lag all of a sudden? That's not cool at all. My frames just like dropped like clean to 4 frames per second. What the heck is going on? Why did I just drop to single frame rate? Single digit frame rate. Why am I suddenly getting all kinds of lag? What is going on? Lag, could you please go away? Especially since there's a bunch more zombies over here. And I'm trying to do melee. Okay, why am I suddenly lagging so bad? It's not like it started scanning or something. I don't know why it's lagging all of a sudden. Alright, it's back up to 20 now. I'm like so distracted, I don't even know if I'm doing the right thing now because I got so sidetracked by the sudden crazy lag. Fall back to Fort Trinity Center. Ignore the arrow and go up the stairs. Or ramp, as it is. It's just hard for me to say much when it's like base game story because I've done it so many times. I'm doing that already. Would you stop repeating yourself, Treherny baby? Keep it up, you're gonna get like trapped in a vine or something. Sorry. Okay. Oh, because you left people out there? Whatever. They're NPCs. Stands for non-player corpse. They'll be fine. Yes, find some more gate switches. Find being the operative term. Okay, they're over there. Behind all the zombies. Don't mind me, zombies. I'm just going over here. Oh, you're gonna pull that crap, you know? My necks have that power, too. Bet you wouldn't like it if I decided to use it on you, huh? I think it's called Dark Feast or something, I don't know. Feast of Corruption. It's some weird feast thing. There's a feast in it somewhere. But she has staff, so it's not one of the staff skills. I want to say axe, maybe? I don't know. Head to the Asira Gates. Yay. That sounds fun. I need that hero challenge. But I can't get it during this BS. Let me get my hero challenge. I still have to, like, remind myself to call them hero points and hero challenges. I'm so used to calling them skill points. Alright. Yeah. I know, I need to blow it up. Blowing things up is always a good idea. Would you shush? I don't know who Tawn is unless I did that story. And I didn't do that story on this character, so stop talking to me like I know him. Alright, anyway. It's like you think I've got 30 alts or something, and then I know who you're talking about. Like, do you think I know who Apatia is, too? Bet you do, don't you? Alright, if you say so. I'm gonna steal your blue ball. What do you guys think about that? I'm gonna steal it. Don't talk to me, Treherne. Just let me steal their blue ball. Anyway, see, I always make wrong turns in this silly place. Anybody order a big blue ball? Delivery. Please tip. Okay. I'll take 4,000 gold, then I can get my hair thing. It's like I've been playing for 4 years. The only thing in the game that I want, not legendaries, just my hair contract. My permanent hairstylist contract. It's 4,000 gold and I'll never have 4,000 gold. I'm very upset. Okay, anyway. Yeah, I'm supposed to go kill some stuff, right? But I'm having hair contract withdrawal trauma. Leave me alone. Don't expect me to kill zombies. I'm in no mental state to be doing that. Anyway, the docks. Oh God, why can't I'm? I can never remember how to get back to the docks. I'll follow the NPCs and hope they know where they're going, because I'm sure they do, right? And I always try to jump down there, and then I get caught behind that thing. I want to glide. Let me glide. The zombies just stand around waiting on me to get here. That's nice of them. There, I tried not clicking my thing since I'm melee. For now. Why are you people all being dead? Don't you be AoE-ing me. I do not enjoy it in the slightest. My cat just jumped up in the desk and he's like sniffing the microphone and my face. Apparently he thinks something interesting is going on. I don't know. Kitty, you've seen me record 700 times. Why is it so interesting to you tonight? I'm killing zombies here. Can't be having kitties in my face. Anyway. La 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 la, this cutscene is being a little bit slow. Hey, we did it. Yay and crap. Right? Sure. Maybe I'll stop it here, but it would only be half an hour. I know, most people won't even watch anything over 5 minutes. And I think that a video should at least be an hour. Uh-huh. And I'm sure that it's not like killing the dragons will cause any unforeseen circumstances. Mm-hmm. Really? Because we cleared Orr's little lands out about 5 years ago and there's still zombies all over the place, so something went wrong. Yeah, Anet, get on that. Why is there still zombies all over Orr? Do phasing or something. All of us people that cleared out Orr 5 years ago are sick of freaking zombies. But anyway. They'll never do that. It's a nice dream, though.
Trinity is secure for now, so if you have no objection,
miss a chance like that, sir. Just have to destroy us both, and I will be seeing an answer for it.
Agreed. I'll wrap things up here, and then meet you near the signal peak camp.
Okay, so apparently I don't have to walk all over Fireheart and Frost Gorge. That's if you investigate Siska's background. That's when you got to do that, because I think this camp he wants to meet us at is actually in Straits of Devastation. Power, Ferocity, Vitality. Precision, Toughness, Power. Power, Ferocity, Precision. We'll go with this one because Power and Ferocity are important for Reapers, and she's in people's faces, so Vitality is probably a good plan, too. Okay. Yeah, I guess we're done. Aren't we, kids? Dead zombies everywhere. Had some kind of a party here. Alright. Anyway, let's get away from all these annoying people. So I guess I'll stop it at half an hour. Like I said, I normally like my videos to be about an hour each, but it's already 2:30 in the morning, and I know nobody will watch anything that's more than 5 minutes anyway. So I guess I'll end it here, and we'll do this one sometime this week, hopefully, and also the rest of the Caladbog stuff, and whatever else strikes my fancy if I can get a chance to record. And as always, if you want to find me in the game, you're more than welcome to add me, talk to me. Come join my guild. We definitely need more people. It's Nocturna.7689, so hit me up. Come join us. We're just a very, very tiny group of friends who just help each other out with stuff. Nothing too complicated, right? And it's also Game of Thrones themed. So anyway, yeah. Find me in game. Join my guild. Say hi. Whatever you like. And I'll try to get another video out tomorrow if I can. So, bye-bye for now.